Hi guys, and welcome to another video. In the last episode, I didn't have this huge area cleared out. I went ahead and I did that off camera, and yeah, so we'll eventually start moving stuff out of this building that we've got here and out into this space. The idea that I've got so far, and this may change, but I want to do farms like on this outer ring, so 4, 5, 6, 7, these 7 squares here, and then this inner, like, 3x3 area will be the area that I build my base stuff in. So probably the center will be like where my storage is all at, and then outside is where I'll put all my machines. I may try to separate this out by mod or something like that. I don't really know what I want to do here, but I'll probably have separate buildings for each one. And then I'll probably do some sort of height offset, so some buildings will be shorter than others, so it looks a little bit nicer. I'm going to try not to make them this ugly, but I don't know. We'll see. Again, I do want to, I will replace the cobblestone eventually. Right now, I'm just leaving it. It's fine. But the cobblestone pathways and buildings and all that will get replaced eventually. Today, though, I want to get started on something else. So I went ahead and I made some of these Z-Logic controllers. If you guys don't know, you can actually automate this thing with a hopper by putting the resources up here. So I made a bunch of these just in case we needed them. Well, yeah, more in the future. I want to take a look at a farm block from Ender.io. It's actually called a farming station. It requires these pulsating crystals, which are diamonds with pulsating iron. And pulsating iron is something that I'm going to need more of. So let's take a look here and see what the recipe is. So it's iron and an ender pearl, so we'll do that. We're getting a little bit low on ender pearls, so we'll have to go to the end and get some more soon. So, but that's not too big of a deal. We'll go ahead and grab some iron, and we'll get this stuff started here. Let me just make sure that's in alloys only. Perfect. Cool. And we've also got some solarium that I made, so I'll go ahead and toss this into our system here so we have it when we need it. Cool. So then that just requires diamonds, and I've made a diamond hoe, but I'll probably make a couple more as I need them. So let's go ahead and grab these guys. We'll just go ahead and turn half of them into that, and then let's go ahead and make a few of these. So we've got 9. We probably want to make one more. So let's do that. We'll do one more. Diamond. Right. And then I actually have pulsating crystal. I'm overcrafting just so in case I need them later, I'll have some. And actually, we can toss those in there. So we should have everything we need to make at least one of these. There we go. And if I want to make more, let's go ahead and make a couple diamond hoes here really quickly. 1, 2. So we'll go ahead and make 2 more of these guys. 1, 2. Cool. So we've got 3 farming stations. Now, like I said, I want to set these up over here. So I think I'll start with this furthest space right here. And we'll do something like this. I think these can reach the entire space here. I'll have to figure out how I'm going to handle lighting, but for now, this should be good. Now, I will eventually replace these with unbreaking hose from Tinker's Construct. For now, I think I've got... let's just make a couple stone hose. Okay, so that should be good. And like I said, I'll replace those with... the unbreakable ones from Tinker's Construct, so not a big deal. And then basically you put whatever you want it to grow in there. So I think the first one we're gonna do, let's just do like this. So wheat seeds, I wanna do potatoes. And I don't really know why I wanna do these farms, to be honest. It's not like I need them, but it would be kinda nice to have them. And what else do I wanna do? I kind of want to do some of the Pam's Harvest Craft stuff, but maybe I won't do that today. Let me see here, see if I can spot something that I would like to have. You know, you used to be able to do, like, flowers and stuff, but I don't know what mod that was from. You could farm flowers. That was actually really useful. We may just do strawberries. I mean, that can't hurt anything, right? We'll just do a couple of these guys. We'll do 4. And we'll farm some strawberries up. Okay, so the way that these work, if I understand, so you put the hoe in there, and then you give it the seeds that you want it to use, and then the output's over here. So then you can give it some power. So I'm going to have to string some power along. For now, it's going to be temporary, so just keep that in mind. Do I have any in here? Okay. So we'll string some of this along, and like I said, it's temporary, so this will get replaced later. We'll go ahead and just do it like this. So it should be able to reach here and then there, and then maybe we'll do it like right here. Okay, and then we'll grab our laser wrench. I don't know if this will reach. Okay, cool. So that'll send power over to here, and then we'll go ahead and place one of these on top, and that should provide power to the block here. Cool. Okay, cool. So that worked really well. Hey, got a worm. Let's go ahead and... Oh, I guess if we just give it more seeds, it'll continue planting then. Awesome. Okay, so it planted 1, 2, 3, 7 by 7. So that's not bad. And we could then put like water underneath that block there. And that would cover this whole area. I think if you put capacitors in here, I'm curious. I need to see. Let's go ahead and grab some of these guys. So we'll grab one of each. We'll do this guy first. So we get him out. And we'll do one of these. Yeah, auto crafting is so helpful. Okay, and then we'll just see, because I think each one adds like a ring around it. So like the basic capacitor is just going to make it go one block further, if I could find it. So we'll throw that there. Or maybe it doesn't do anything, the basic one. Okay, so let's try the second tier. Okay, so that's making it go two blocks further, it looks like. Let's go ahead and grab these torches out of here so it's not confusing it. Oops. And we'll go ahead and plant these guys back. Let's see if I can grab... Do I have it on me? I think I've got my Torturino. I may have left it over here. Yep. So let's go ahead and see if we can get this to grow just a little bit so we can get some seeds back out of it. Oh, broke the hoe. Okay. So let's go ahead and throw a new hoe back in there. Cool. Very simple. And so it should be getting seeds and then being able to use those seeds to replant. And you can see it's actually not evenly distributing. So let's go ahead and lock these in place so that it'll only use... Actually, hang on. We can unlock these. Well, it don't matter. We'll lock them. And then what we can do is then give it another hoe. And any... Hello? Wind advisory in effect. Okay, thanks. Thanks, phone. So any seeds that go in here are automatically being replanted, which is cool. I'm like, why is it only growing over here? It's because I've got my Torturino over here. Cool. So that leaves a one block border, and I actually really like the way that that works. So I'm going to go ahead and leave it like that. Let's go ahead and grab our Torturino. It should go ahead and plant a guy there. It'll take a little bit because that guy was being sped up by the Torturino here. But that's fine. And then I don't know if we'll have to worry about lighting or not. If we do have to worry about it, we may put some of those powered lights up here. But yeah, we'll see. If we take out... Let's go ahead and take out the output here. There we go. And that'll clean that all up. So that's really nice. I like that a lot. So that's wheat, and then that was just using this level capacitor. I do want to see what the octetic does, although it's probably... Let's go ahead and see if we can grab some dirt here really quickly and see how far it'll go, because I think the octetic is a couple layers even further than this one was. Yeah, see? So, and I really don't want it all the way to the edge here. I really liked having it... just as far as it was there. So I think I'm going to just use that regular capacitor, or the, it's the double layer capacitor for that. And that'll be good. So let's go ahead and replace this stuff here. Oops. Right. So that should be good. And then we'll do the same thing for the other farms. And man, it sucks. So these laser relays, let's go ahead and test it really quick, but I'm almost certain that this is how they work. They have a max distance of 15 blocks. At least that's what it says in the manual. So I don't know if that means 15 blocks plus the block that they're in. Yeah, so you can see that they're too far apart there. So if I wanted to link these guys like that, I actually have to run like a secondary line down this direction in order to get them close enough together to see each other. So like this guy and that guy, and this guy and that guy, this guy and that guy, and like that. So in order to get the power to run, that's how you have to do it. So I'll have to figure out a better way to do it. I may throw these underneath the floor here. I'm not entirely sure, but we'll see. And then there's actually even... Okay. There's actually even an item transfer version of these that'll transfer items instead of power. So I may look into that as well. I'm going to go ahead and grab all this outer layer so it goes back to being grass. And that should just dry up after a little bit. So I'm going to go ahead and set these guys up as well. So we've got... Oh, shoot. I should have made a fourth one, I guess. Well, I guess three is fine. So I'm going to get the other one set up, and I'll be right back. All right, guys. Welcome back. This is actually really fun to watch. Like, it's... Watch. It's great. I'm definitely not going to leave the Torturino sitting here. And, man, that's breaking hose fast. I was trying to just get it to fill up the whole area, which it's done now. So we'll go ahead and leave that, and we'll do this one next. So same deal. Right. Make those grow, and then we'll have to keep replacing the hose until it fills up the whole area. And it looks good. So that's the whole deal. So we're good. So we've got some farms. That's wheat, carrots, or potatoes, and then carrots. I may add some other farms off camera, but I think that's good. That's all we really need. And then we're going to need to figure out how to pull items out of here. Now, I have a crazy idea. I saw a block from Actually Additions that I think does exactly what I want to do here. But we'll have to see. Because there's a couple things. I need to replace the hoe, right? And then I also need to pull out the output. And I really don't want to run Ender IO conduit all over the place here. Now, I could use an Ender IO. They have a Tesseract type item. Can't remember what it's called. Could use that. I want to avoid that as well. Let's go ahead and toss the last one in here. Might as well. Yeah. So... Right. What was I saying? Something about... Yeah, so there's a block... from Actually Additions. Let's go ahead and toss these items away really quickly here. I want to show you this block really quickly. All right, so Actually Additions, and it's called a Phantom Face. Phantom Face. It's basically an interface that you can... I definitely don't have any of the blocks for it, so I have to set everything up for it. But it allows you to... Let's look at the uses here. And we'll go back a page. Phantom faces are a simple way to connect inventories together. They have very important twist. Instead of connecting two inventories, a phantom face simulates the inventory it is connected to, meaning you can put items and pull items out of the phantom face itself. So if you guys remember, Thaumcraft 3 had an item like this, and it's basically, so you put down a block, right? Let's just pretend that's a block. You put down this block, and then you use some sort of linking tool to link this block to that block. And then if you put like a pipe, an extracting pipe to pull items out of this block, it pulls them out of that block remotely. So that's what the phantom face sounds like it's going to do for us. And if that's what it does, there's also some other ones that seem super useful that can really help make this look really good. So like right now we've got the laser relay on top. I'd want to throw that below, but I also want to give the farms water. So I would kind of want to put a water source there, and yeah, it gets confusing from there. So you can actually look in here. Let's see. So there's a red phantom energy face, which basically does the same thing with energy. There's one for liquids, and there's also one for redstone. So you can basically do everything remotely, and it does it, I think it says like in a 15 block radius or something like that. Let's take a look. Let's go back here. Right-clicking in inventory, phantom connector, phantom face. It's not a wireless transport system. Yeah, it basically doesn't want you to use it as a tesseract. Let's go back. 16 blocks. Default range is 16 blocks. You can upgrade it with a Phantom booster. You can right-click an inventory with a Phantom connector and connect it. Yeah, so I'm going to try to make this. In order to do that, though, I do need to set up that empowerer, and I really don't want to do it in here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start getting this area ready, and I'm probably going to use one of these exterior areas here for the empowerer. Eventually, I want to automate the empowerer, so I have to build it with that in mind. So give me a little bit. I'm going to figure out how I want to do all of that, and I will be right back. All right, guys, welcome back. So I went ahead and set this up. I forgot an important step. Dang it. I have to link these. So I put laser relays underneath here to bring the power in. And I'm sort of going through these faster than I was wanting to, but that's okay. Connect these guys, connect that guy, and yeah, that's not going to let me, and then we'll connect to this guy, and that should be good. So these guys will all get power now, so that's good, and then we'll go ahead and replace the floor. Now again, I want to automate this, and maybe here isn't where I'm going to do that. That's why I sort of left it simple and I didn't run any cables. I'll eventually replace those laser relays with cables because their cables are cheaper, right? But yeah, for now, that's good. We do need to get some diamond blocks and empower those. So let's go ahead and do that first. So, what in the world? No, I have diamonds. What could I have used all my diamonds on? Hello? Really? Okay, maybe I'm out of diamonds. Let's go ahead and grab some from up here. That's odd. Right? That's it? That's all the diamonds we've got? Oh, there's some diamond ore. Okay. And then let's make sure we're fortuning that properly. Hello? 1 and 2 and 3 and... Builder's wand up. Very cool. Aha! Cool. Now we're good on diamonds. So we're going to do 2 diamond blocks and empower both of them. And in fact, actually, block. Yeah, sorry. They auto-block themselves up, so that's cool. So let's do that. We'll empower both of these. Let's take a look at the uses. Oh, that's right. We have to atomically reconstruct them. So let's do the laser. Atomic... so let's go ahead and, since I don't have a place for this, we're going to do it here. Where do I want to do this? Let's do it like that. Right. And then we'll do like this and then we'll get a button. Should be good. Very cool. Okay, so then these are the diamantine crystals, and then you look up the uses on those, and then 2 clay, 1 clay block, and 1 light blue dye. So, light blue dye. All right, that should be it. So let's go ahead and run this through really quickly. And this is why I want to automate it, because this is tedious. And 1 clay block. Ta-da! All right, so I've got 2 of those. Let's go ahead and we're going to break these out into the regular form. So we'll hold on to those, and then... there it is. Phantom face. So it's a chest, a block of emerald, or enderpearl, block of emerald, advanced coil, which I'll probably need to make a couple of these, quartz. Dang it, black quartz. Why don't you just work? Does this work in here yet? No. That's okay. We'll just smelt it up. Not a big deal. There we go. And we'll torturino this for just a little bit. That should be good. Let's go ahead and do that. So we'll do 2 of those. We're gonna need more, but that's okay. We'll do this for now. So one, two, and then we'll do this guy. One, two of those, and one. Let's do one more. Two. Cool. So that's awesome. Now let's take a look. We also need a phantom. Can't remember what it's called. Phantom booster? No. Connector. Phantom connector. That's weird. Okay, so two Eyes of Ender. Blaze. Okay. Go ahead and run these through here. Perfect. So two of these and two of, yeah, that'll work. Cool. So phantom connector, and then let's go ahead. I'm going to just grab a chest because I want to show you guys the concept here, because it's, if you haven't seen it before, it might be a bit confusing. Where is, okay, so we'll place the chest down, and we'll place down the phantom face, and that goes like there, for example. And it says it's not connected to anything, so let's go ahead and grab our phantom connector, right-click that guy, right-click that, oh, block stored, and then block connected. Okay, so you can see it's connected to block, oak chest, blah, 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 three blocks away. It's fine and working. And then, okay, so we'll open this. You see there's nothing in there. Let's grab a hopper is the easiest thing I can show. Right? Pretty basic. And what we can do is throw the hopper, like, on the side here, and then throw an item in there. You'll see the items go into this block, which means they're actually going into the chest. So that's the phantom face. And it's amazing. That's amazing. So what that allows us to do then... And, okay, let's do this, too. Let's go ahead and break this guy. Okay, go ahead and break that, and then we'll grab our cobblestone back out of here. Let's go ahead and put this up by a couple blocks. Oh, actually, yeah, let's do that. Let's go ahead and put one here. Right? Then we'll put the hopper here. Okay, so it's pulling out, right? So then let's go ahead and throw a stack of cobble in here, and then let's go ahead and connect that guy to that guy and check that out. So it's also, it'll also work for pulling items out, which is super cool. All right. So that makes a whole lot of sense. Hopefully it's kind of crazy, but it's awesome. If we wanted to be really crazy, I think you can even connect multiple things. Yeah. So this is... Yeah, it's not going to do anything, obviously, because it's pulling out and putting into the same block, which is crazy, but that's a thing you can do. So you can have multiple things connected to the same block. And, oh, that's cool. So it kind of shows the link. So cool. You get the idea. That's what it does. We probably need to make one more of these for the third farm, but let's go ahead and try to get these working for now. So I'll have to dig up an area below the farms. So let's go ahead and do that. I'll go ahead and do that off camera, and I'll be right back. You know, conveniently, there's a whole area under here already, so we don't actually need to dig much out. So what I'm going to do... how do I want to do this? I've got to figure out... So I've got to do two things. One, I've got to refill the thing with hose if I'm going to use the stone hose, which I really don't want to use, so maybe we don't worry about that. The other thing that I need to do is just pull items out of there, right? So that's not hard to do at all. I kind of want to do this like below here. Let's see. Like somewhere here, like where is that centerpiece? Is over here somewhere. Right. Let's go ahead and poke a hole up here. Where are we at? Okay, cool. So I'm going to put this block here. Just so we'll know where it's at all times, right? And then let's go ahead and, oops, crouch right click here. And then crouch right click there. Bam. So now this guy is connected to the farming station, right? So then we can use, just as an example, we won't actually use this, but we can use the hopper to pull the items out. Very cool. So that's how we're going to use that. And then I do need some way of pulling those and putting them back into our system here. So I kind of want to look at the item relay from Actually Editions as well. So let's take a look here. So you can see there's actually like the energy ones that we're using. There's a fluid one, an item one, and then an advanced item one. So we're going to go ahead and do... Oh, and you just use an energy laser relay, which is relatively cheap. So let's go ahead and make one of those. We'll need some redstone blocks. Oh, and we've actually got some. So let's go ahead and take a couple of these guys. So one, two... Oh, shoot, that scared me. I forget that the redstone blocks themselves will actually power the... There we go. Power the other ones. Let's do a few more. So we'll do them in this order this time. Aha! Tricked it. Cool. So I think 16 will be good to get us started here, and we'll go ahead and pull those back out into their crystal form. Cool. So let's go ahead and make some of these energy laser relays. What do you need in the center here? Oh, and an advanced coil, one of those. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We'll do 6 for now. Cool. And then we'll do that. And then we'll see if we can do... Let's do 8 then. 8 of these, and then let's turn those into item laser relays. Very cool. So it's just the advanced coil again. So 1... Yeah, let's toss these in here, too. We need those coils again. Dang it. Oops. We'll do 6 more of those. Right, and then item laser relay. Cool. So now we've got 8 item laser relays, and these work the same way, basically, as the power does. There's one other item that we actually need for them, and I actually don't remember. Let's take a look at the manual. So, next to build a fully-fledged sword system, multiple chests, pulling out of what? Oh, geez. Later laser items relays work like the energy version, but instead of transferring energy, they transfer items around. The basic mechanics of the item are much the same. Once a connection is set up to a network or system, said network will know about all the inventories adjacent to all the relays and will be able to interact with them. However, item interfaces are the way to actually communicate and interact with the entire system. So item interfaces is how you pull items out and put items in. So, right, so we'll go ahead and make a couple of these. More crafting. And I haven't messed with these too much, so let's... Well, at all, I should say. I haven't messed with these at all, so I don't know exactly how it all works. Oops, I did not mean to make 21 of those. That's okay. We probably needed it anyway. What am I missing? Really? I can't believe I used all that. I had 100 and something of those. Oops. All right. It's not too big of a deal. We can always make more, right? Let's do these in here. That's fine. Okay, so let's do that. So we'll make a couple of these. Maybe 4 should be good. All right, and then let's go ahead and try to set up this network that they're talking about. So if I put this laser item relay there, and let's just, for the sake of simplicity, we're just going to put another one up here and put our chest next to it. And then let's go ahead and connect one of these item interfaces to it. And then we have to take our laser wrench and then link these guys. Okay, so those should be connected to each other. And now the question is, how does it actually work? let's go ahead and hop up here. I want to say that this is the block that you pull items in and out of the network with. So if I put Yeah, you can see that's going into there, and then that's being stored here through the laser. So if we had then, let's go ahead and break this. If we don't give it a place to put the items, I bet you the items stop flowing. So let's go ahead and take a look here. So it doesn't have anywhere to put them because it can't insert them over there. So let's take a look at putting this chest over here then with another laser, and then we'll wirelessly transfer from here to there. And yeah, so you can see now it's got a place to store them. So let's go ahead and break this and this, and let's see if we can take this. Oh man, I'm making a mess. Let's go ahead and do something like this. So we'll put this guy up here, right? And then we'll put a hopper below it. Right, so that's not gonna do anything because it's not got a laser connected to it. But if we then take an item laser relay there, and then let's go ahead and link that guy. Right, so those are connected, and now it should be pulling items. So it's gonna pull them from the chest because there's items in there, and then it should start pulling them from the farm if I understand correctly, which I don't clearly understand correctly. So I thought that this guy would be able to interact with that directly. I could be wrong, I guess. Let's try this. Let's go ahead and put down the chest. No, that's not what I wanted to do. Let's go ahead and break this guy. Oops. Let's put down the chest over here, and then let's link this guy to this guy. So connected oak chest. So then, let's see if we throw something in here. Oh, okay, so it does work that way. But apparently it can't pull items out of this block. Oh, there are no items in this block, duh. Okay, let's go ahead and reconnect that. Go like this, store the connection there, and then reconnect it there. Okay, cool. So that should work, and then all we actually need to do is get this guy to actually do something. Let's go ahead and fill this in really quickly here. And let's give this guy another stone hoe. Actually, I think I have some other hoe in here. Oops. Yeah, we'll just use the emerald hoe for this for now. So then, yeah, this is a little bit confusing, but I think we've got it. So if I throw this in there. Oh, it doesn't take it, really? Okay. Game, come on. Work with me, game. Let's go ahead and make a stone hoe. All right, that should be good to get us going. Perfect. Right, and then once it starts harvesting things, those things should end up in... Oh, look at that. Okay. That's complicated, but it's not that complicated. Okay, so, and that's what's really cool about that is I actually only need one of these to interface with all of my farms to pull the items out. So let's go ahead. I'm going to do this off camera, but I'm going to go ahead and create a relay network for all of these and get them all connected up to this so that they're outputting their items into this. So yeah, I'm going to do that off camera because it's a little bit, blech. it's not fun to watch. So, I'll be back with you guys in just a little bit. All right, guys, welcome back. So I've gone ahead and connected those phantom faces down there to each of these blocks, and I've got an item or a laser relay here, and I'm actually going to, this is stupid. I'm going to, don't worry. It's fine. We're going to do this, and I'll fix this later. I just want to prove the concept and make sure that I'm not being dumb about this. So I put an item interface here, and I put a hopper below here, right? This should start collecting items once I connect the laser relay, right? So that's connected to the network there, and now that's pulling potatoes, which proves that this one's working. So let's go ahead and wait for the potatoes to clear out. Yeah, so we'll wait for the potatoes to clear out, and then we should start getting these guys. And I wanted to test the theory that, well, let's go ahead and make another hopper. I've been trying to avoid that, but whatever, hoppers are useful. Hopper, it's not like they're expensive, right? That's fine. 1, 2. That should be good. So what I want to try, and actually let's go ahead and make a stone hoe. Yeah, that's fine. I think you can actually, we're already able to replenish the hoes in this system. So if we just throw hoes in here, check that out. So that's actually going to insert those into the correct slot and everything. So this is, oh, and man, let's just prove the point that those hoes are working. Let's grab our, this guy. Where is he? Oh, I put it down. Dang it. Let's grab our Torturino and just run one of these guys really quickly and prove that the hoe breaking replacement works. Let's go ahead and do it on this farm. Right? Okay. So the hoe's durability is going down, down, down. New hoe. Check it out. That's amazing. And now we're running into a situation where actually the hopper down here isn't keeping up. What in the world? This is crazy. Okay, so not only can I do that though, like, wow, that's crazy, crazy. Okay, cool. So automated farms, awesome. I do want to replace these laser relays because I've got one up there and one down here. I want to try that with these Phantom Energy Face. So these take empowered Redstonia crystals and regular Phantom Faces. So I'm going to go ahead and make three of those to get these farms online. And I want to see if those are as cool as these item ones, because I think they're going to work just fine. And then we'll be able to run the power through the laser relays underground and not have to worry about it. So give me a little bit. I'm going to create those and I will be right back. All right, guys, welcome back. So I've gone ahead and I've connected everything. I'm going to take a look here. I want to grab the output, whoops, from here. So it's going to run down some power. Good. I want to make sure each of these are have a little bit of power needed. Good. Let's take this last one here. A little bit of power needed. Cool. So I've gone ahead and already connected everything. Let's take a look here. I'm going to get rid of some of this crap that's in my inventory. I'll come get it later. Give me that. And okay, cool. Let's go ahead and connect the power. So I've got a relay. Connect the power. So I connected it. Let's go take a look and see. Whoops. Oh, we're gaining power. Okay, cool. So the power is actually flowing, and I'll show you what it looks like. So the power is connected from here, and you'll see it goes down. It goes into this relay here. And I know this one and this one are really close together, but that one and that one were too far apart, so I had to add one here, but that's not a big deal. So it connects to there, and it also connects to this energy interface, and then it connects to there, and another energy interface, and it connects to there, and then one final energy interface here. Now, this is a really messy setup, but I was just basically trying to prove the concept that it actually worked, so it does, and that's awesome. I'm going to actually head down here really quickly. I want to block up these holes and make sure there's no spawnable spaces. Yeah, because there are some. So let's go ahead and grab some torches really quickly. All right, so everything looks pretty well lit down there. So these are all fully, like, fully automated with this weird janky setup here. But, I mean, it works. Check that out. So, obviously, I'll have to do something other than hoppers. But that's farm automation for you. Look at that. That's crazy. And then if I really needed to, I could actually throw, and I probably will, throw a torch on top of those. Get rid of the Torturino here so that we don't have spawning happening here. And yeah, so that's awesome. That's so cool. All right, so we've got fully automated farms here. I'm very happy about that. I do think, I don't know. I want to end the episode here. I do want to end the episode here. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. I'm going to end the episode here. I do want to thank you guys for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I certainly enjoyed this episode. I'm very happy with this setup. If you guys did enjoy the episode, please leave a rating. It really helps me out. I'd appreciate that. And until next time, I will see you guys later.